could be claiming his first ever victory in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. Yeah, and there is a great race for second.
Here's the race for second right here. You saw Musgrave. You could see it getting into turn one. He was going to make a move. Carl's all out front, unsponsored.
The unsponsored 99 Ford of Carl Edwards makes his final turn. Coming out of turn number four, he sees the checkered flag and wins. They come across the start-finish line. The white flag comes out. One lap around this oval here at IRP, and the race for the lead is on. It's Travis Quappel trying to reel in the 99 of Carl Edwards.
And he's up on that wall. He's up on that wheel. He's coming. Look at that.
As he drives hard through three and four, Carl Edwards coming out of turn number four, and Carl Edwards will win the Power Stroke Diesel 200. Coming out of turn number four, the number 99 of Carl Edwards dominates the Federated Auto Parts 200.
What is Mike Wallace's plan? When do you make the move? The race wasn't decided until off of turn four a year ago. Mike knows this.
You make the move too soon and you're going to have three or four guys drive by you. So.
Carl Edwards putting some distance between himself and Mike Wallace. Wallace and Quappel now trying to negotiate their way up closer to the 99 as they work their way down the backstretch and into turn number three. Carl Edwards out in front of Mike Wallace, Travis Quappel, and the defending race champion of this race, Rick Crawford. Coming out of turn number four, dicing, dancing.
Oh, he got sideways.
It's going to be Carl Edwards winning the Florida Dodge Dealers 250.
Meal closing the gap as they go into one and two.
Will we see a little bump and run here, Michael?
Well, I'm thinking that that's what's going to happen next. They race down into turn three. If Shane can get close enough, will he bump him?
Not going to get there.
Not going to happen. Carl Edwards will win the O'Reilly 200 at Bristol Motor Speedway.
He moved up the racetrack and it is really helping him. I mean, he is closing fast now. He's got that high line. He's cutting that gap down, boys. And he's pulling away from Greg Viffle, but he better hurry, Darrell. Lap and a half to go, halfway down the backstretch. He's coming.
4 tenths of a second last lap, 3 tenths of a second, two laps ago. And
this is going to be another one of those Atlantas. I'm telling you, they're going to be side by side when they come to the line next time by.
Here they go, white flag, boys, last time. He's there.
And he cut the margin in less than half.
Hey, boys, watch this. Jimmy goes up high to block him. That may or may not be good.
If he can get that run right here, if he can get it, keep that momentum.
He's going to get a run at him. He'll get one shot at turn three and four.
I'm telling you, they're going to be side by side when they come to the line. It's going to be another one of those fantastic Atlanta finishes.
Johnson tries to block him. It's who can stand the throttle here off turn four.
And here they come, and I think Cole's got the advantage.
Got it.
To the inside, I think he'll take the position going out in turn one.
I think he'll wreck.
Sather tries to pinch him. Sauter having trouble holding off the fourth place car.
He gets him sideways.
I think they might wreck. I think they might wreck, but they saved it.
Here comes Sauter and Kane. It's going to be four cars under a blanket, and the winner, Carl Edwards.
Awesome.
Which meant that we were already into overtime. So that started the green.
The racetrack, cross start finish line, then come all the way back around.
That started the green-white checker scenario, and if the caution comes out after that green flag, the field is frozen at the timing line just passed, and the order of finish determined.
We'll take the checker flag this time, and then you do whatever you want, buddy.
And I don't know if I tell Carl Edwards that or not.
Sparta, Kentucky, works his way back to turn number one.
Yeah, Mark Truex has got a rearview mirror full of Clint Boyer. We got a good battle for second and a gaggle of cars from fifth on back to tenth here with one lap to go, but Carl Edwards is checked out.
What a terrific job by Carl Edwards. Brad Perry, we doubted his call to come in and put tires on it. The caution flag helped him. It's going to bring him the win, Mark.
They took a very big gamble, but it paid off big. The crowd on its feet to cheer Carl Edwards down to the checkered flag. His second Busch Series win of 2005.
I've got two laps to go and they're already shooting the fireworks off.
What's up with that?
I don't know. A little advance there.
They let the fireworks off too.
Fireworks. Don't worry. We still got one more to go.
Keep going. That's what I thought when they shoot the fireworks off for
coming
already.
Coming to the checker, correct?
Yeah.
Four, we're coming to the checker.
You saw those fireworks going down the back stretch. Lenny Doherty won the race. Now Carl Edwards out of turn four. Checkered flag. Carl Edwards wins in California, and the fireworks are official.
That is what you call a team effort. And we as a team will show this racing organization, NASCAR, that we're behind their effort 110% for the relief fund.
Charm, a lot of determination to the Nextel Cup Series.
He has been a breath of fresh air.
Came here in Atlanta, won the Busch race, came back the next day, won the Nextel Cup race. So Benny talked about it. Sweeps have become in fashion here in the Nextel Cup Series, and Carl Edwards sweeps at Atlanta.
Aren't one of the most determined racers in the sport.
Edwards didn't really make up that much ground on Mark that last lap.
No, just about a tenth of a second.
Ooh, he made up some ground there, though. Up on the high side.
Here he comes. Off of four.
Got a good run right there, so this is going to close the gap.
Two to go. 3 miles left in the race.
Mark's going to the bottom. Here goes Edwards to the top.
For the lead, less than two laps to go. Carl Edwards around Mark Martin.
Baby, don't overdo it now. Clear, one back.
Carl's mother watches from pit road. Last
white
lap.
Flag, you're looking at it. Three back.
Pretty impressive.
Unbelievable what that is.
Edwards going for two in a row, won last Sunday in Atlanta. Stewart is sixth, and that really will affect the championship standings as we head for Phoenix next week. Carl Edwards.
You can take a break. It's yours.
It is his. Carl Edwards wins at Texas.
One more mile for Carl Edwards to pick up the win. Boyer not quite close enough to mount a challenge, but still incredible drive today. Matt Kenseth made it fun in the final laps as well. But you want to talk about a driver on the roll. The young man from Missouri behind the wheel of that 60 car, Carl Edwards, racing for a championship on Sundays and another win on Saturday.
Now Casey Mears in the 42 car still running up in the fourth position, has a pretty good lead over fifth place Martin Truex Jr. in the eighth.
Yeah, I think he was having more like fuel pickup issues rather than out of fuel. Tank is so low on fuel, he was just having trouble picking it up. But he's definitely going to make it home.
Carl Edwards' last win, November 2005.
He's got a lap car in between him now. He makes his way around the 90 of Matt McCall on the inside.
Carl Edwards working his way through 3 and 4. As he comes out of turn number 4, he will see the checkered flag and win 7 in the Busch Series.
Last time around for Edwards. Benefited from a caution after the two race leaders have pitted. Down the backstretch for the final time. So Carl Edwards with a racing doubleheader ran the modified race here earlier. And takes the checkered flag at New Hampshire.
Final lap here in St. Louis tonight for Carl Edwards of Columbia, Missouri. Looking for his fourth NASCAR Busch Series win of the season. A tremendous fight between he and Denny Hamlin. But Carl's crew got the strategy right, got him out in position to take advantage of fresh tires and speed to get by Hamlin and take the lead with 9 laps to go. Final corner coming up. And the checkered flag is up for Carl Edwards. A very popular win. He takes tonight's Busch Silver celebration
for Carl Edwards, trying to hold off the 17 of Matt Kenseth and the 5 of Kyle Busch. Here comes Busch pedaling for all he's worth, but they will not get it done as Carl Edwards takes the victory.
One lap to go.
4.4.
That's the gap. You just heard it from the spotter. Carl knows it's well in hand.
We talked earlier about everybody was talking about Edwards. He's the guy to beat. A lot of experience, got a good team behind him, quality driver. And Andy, it looks like he's just put a whooping on these guys all day long. Every time he gets in the back, he gets himself right to the front. Car's got great looking attitude on the racetrack.
Looks good.
And the checkered flag flies for the 11th time in his career. Carl Edwards, he goes back-to-back after winning at Bristol and extends his points lead.
But we've got caution.
Final lap. White flag has already been waving, so it will come down to the checkered flag as the caution is out. And the
wave. Carl Edwards has won the race for sure.
Yeah,
Carl, do we want it? Carl. Yeah, we want it. Great job. Good job, everybody.
27-year-old driver from Columbia, Missouri will come out of turn four as he gets ready to come down and take his fourth win of the season. And Carl Edwards will go back to back to back and get the wins at Nashville Super Speedway. Carl Edwards takes it.
2005, he had four wins, finished third in the chase. Last year, he struggled almost the entire season, never found his way to victory lane. Just after Memorial Day, he spent a day on the USS Enterprise with over 5,500 sailors. Signed autographs for an hour, got to launch F-18s off the deck. He said they inspired him. Carl Edwards off of Ford after 52 races without a victory. Carl Edwards wins at Michigan.
Carl Edwards could lock himself into the chase for the Nextel Cup if he hangs on and wins it tonight. It would be his second win in 2007. And Carl Edwards will come down and take the checkered flag out of turn four as a winner in Bristol, Tennessee. Less than a mile to go for Carl Edwards. Trying to take over the lead in the chase for the Nextel Cup. Trying to become the first driver to lead the NASCAR Busch and the NASCAR Nextel Cup point standings. Two turns away from victory at the Monster Mile. And here he comes down. Carl Edwards picks up win number three in 2007.
Has the white flag, one to go.
Pass Joe Nemechek, who will finish 34th today.
Just tiptoe, baby, just tiptoe.
Yeah, with Clear and Nemechek, he's pretty much got smooth sailing, getting close to half a lap to go.
Don't let go of that wood. Don't wave at anybody. Just bring her home.
Looking for his seventh top six finish in eight starts here in Southern California.
Got a spin.
Turn the wall.
Jarrett.
The caution is out, so the field is frozen. The race is over right there because we're on the white flag lap.
Dale Jarrett's car rolls down from the banking.
Once you enter into the white flag lap and there's a caution, the race is over.
Yellow came out after the white flag.
Checkered flag. Carl Edwards wins the Auto Club 500.
One here. He's looking around. He's looking inside. He's looking outside.
You got good gap here. Run away with it.
Biffles to the outside of Junior off of two. Can't quite get there.
He'll have one more shot as Carl Edwards pulls away. Half a lap to go.
Carl's loving this. He's looking in the mirror saying, bye-bye, boys.
Harvick coming into the picture.
See you at the casino.
Single file. Biffle looks high.
Whoa, Biffle.
And for the ninth time in his Sprint Cup career, Carl Edwards will go to victory lane.
Two in a row. Way to go, Carl. Left the outside open, I'll have to say that.
Here comes Clint Bowyer with those two fresh tires. He's going for third, going down into turn one, side by side.
Almost four wide back where Newman and Kenseth battle.
Well, Kenseth is in trouble, we see that.
Here comes
smoke.
Here comes Clint Bowyer again with those two fresh tires, going up into three. We'll be coming to the white flag, he's side by side with Kyle Busch.
Three wide again.
That's exciting. That's exciting for third, but ain't much happening
up here.
This
time, four back.
Carl Edwards running away. The battle is back at sixth place.
Yeah, those guys that got tires are fighting with each other big time.
Yes, they are. Newman, Kenseth, Tony Stewart, Jeff Burton on the outside, and Denny Hamlin. That's a hornet's nest.
Coming to the checkered flag.
Matt Kenseth's a big old sandwich.
Carl Edwards off turn four. Will win the Samsung 500.
Oh, we got Clint Bowyer sideways.
Denny Hamlin and Bowyer got together.
Hours on a jet airplane, two different helicopter rides, back of the field to the front of the field. And the 2007 NASCAR Nationwide Series champion may just be getting back to being a winner in 2008.
Carl's saying, I'm back. He's back.
A little extra weight in the airplane going home. He'll have the iron in there.
It's because of his head. He's going to have a big head going home tonight.
Coming out of turn four, and Carl Edwards goes back to victory lane for the first time in 2008. Final lap here for cousin Carl. Carl Edwards in the Roush Fenway Ford. How good is it for Carl Edwards, who grew up with a little boy wanting to win here? He did it in 2006. And now coming out of turn four, the kid from Columbia, Missouri wins at Gateway. Carl Edwards gets win number two in 2008. Pass-through penalty being called for the 18. If he can get back on the racetrack, going to be a moot point here. But the question is, does Carl have enough fuel on the final lap?
Team's holding their breath right here. You can't see the car. All you're looking towards turn three and just hoping you see that car come off the corner. So far, so good for Carl. Into the tunnel turn.
And Carl is back in the throttle because
this is the last lap, right? To be checker flag this time, bye, bud.
We said this team has been performing exceptionally well, and they've done everything right today. On the racetrack, in the pits, making the right calls, and it's going to get them another victory, it looks like.
Great call. Outstanding strategy and an impressive drive by Carl Edwards. He takes win number four on the season.
You are a wheel man. Cannot live without you, brother.
And Carl Edwards will get the win.
Caution is out.
So for the first time in his NASCAR Nationwide Series career, Carl Edwards is a winner at Michigan. Carl Edwards trying to come down and get win number five. The all-important bonus points, 10 bonus points per win. Remember, he didn't get the bonus points for the Las Vegas win because of the violation they had with the oil tank cover. Here he comes out of turn four. And for the second time in 2008, a driver sweeps both events. Carl Edwards will win it Saturday and Sunday at Michigan. Carl Edwards won here at Bristol in August of 2007, a year ago.
Takes the white flag.
White flag, buddy.
Less than half a mile from back-to-back victories for Carl Edwards. Down the back straightaway. Got a hammer in turn three. Got some traffic in front of him. And Carl Edwards will come down and win for the second time in his career in Bristol, Tennessee.
Edwards is going to win this race.
Carl Edwards comes out of turn four and wins at Richmond.
Flag this time by.
One flag, one more time.
Carl Edwards looking to win here at Memphis. He's got the lead by, about 4 feet. Here comes Kenny Wallace. Can he get into the mix? Down the back stretch for the final time.
Anything can happen going into three. I won a race here last year, or years ago, and it's not going to happen. He won't have nothing for him.
Coming out of turn four, Carl Edwards with David Rudiman all over his back bumper, and it's going to be Edwards, and the championship is on.
Carl Edwards will come down and win for the seventh time in 2008, and Jimmy Johnson finishes second.
Amazing. We see the guy that's getting ready to win this race getting passed by everybody on the racetrack, but he's on a different agenda.
It's just Jeff Gordon back there.
Half a lap.
If he can make it half a lap, he will narrow almost 80 points off of Jimmy Johnson's lead. He said if we can just get it down to 100 or less at Homestead, we got a shot.
I like his chances from here.
Wow,
what a call.
He's gonna make it.
What a call.
Coming out of turn four, what a call. Carl Edwards gets it done and wins at Texas.
Flag.
Home spin, Joey Logano.
He's He's able to collect it back. No caution. Still green. No caution yet. That's another spot for Bowyer.
They're still racing.
Bowyer still going.
Still under green flag, and Carl Edwards pulling away.
18 car gets second spot, getting into turn three.
Here Bowyer's up to fourth.
Here comes Denny Hamlin. Does he have enough time to get there? He is coming in a hurry out of turn four. Here comes Hamlin. Here comes Edwards. And it's a half a car length, and Edwards will get the win. Half a lap away.
Doesn't look like Kyle Busch is going to have anything for Carl Edwards in his final turns.
Coming out of turn four, Carl Edwards will win the battle, but will not win the war. Edwards will win the race, and the 2008 NASCAR Nationwide Series champion is Clint Bowyer.
He'll get out of the gas and just coast.
Here's the sixth car, David Ragan now moving in. Ragan back in third position.
Only two laps to go, less than that now for Carl Edwards.
Here's the 18 of Kyle Busch going by Ragan for position. Now Kyle takes third and one.
Second lead, I keep slowing down.
Okay, it's hard to tell whether he's out of fuel or not. Just how slow he's running. Yeah. He's still running.
Tell me how big my lead is now. 15 seconds, bud. 13 second lead.
Okay, it's a white flag here, guys.
What am I looking for, Bob? Six car.
Okay, now the 29 car is in second place, and he is another 13 seconds back. All Carl has to do is just make sure this thing will come around to the finish.
10-second lead now, bud.
Final lap for Carl Edwards, who has led the most laps, trying to coast home with yet another win in 2008.
He's going to make it, guys.
Off of turn
here
four.
He comes.
Out of turn four.
Craig, great job. It's running out right now. We're out again.
Carl Edwards gets his ninth win of the year, and Jimmy Johnson makes history. Carl Edwards from the back of the pack, just like a year ago at Milwaukee, comes to Milwaukee, and finally, in 2009, cousin Carl will break through and get his first win of the season.
Here comes Carl. He takes his 22nd Nationwide Series win. Second place, Kyle Busch.
And this is going to be the longest last lap of his life. I mean, this has been so hard for him to get around this track with all these caution flags, but he looks great right now. But Carl Edwards, don't count him out. He's closed in on him.
He knows exactly. Listen to the fans cheering these guys as they go by.
Marcus Ambrose has been flawless all day long. He just has to make a few more corners to get this thing home.
Carl Edwards trying to do everything he can to get close for one more final dive on him, but I don't think it's going to happen. Marcus has just been that superior today.
I'll tell you, Carl Edwards not letting him get away from him too far.
Now, this track's drying out pretty good right now. Carl's getting some good bite on these dry sections of the racetrack and actually running them down just a little bit.
Looks like he has closed the gap.
Long way to go still when you think about it in Marcus Ambrose's eyes. Heading down into eight. That's the final time there. So only one more real good opportunity for him.
The Carl Edwards is right there. I mean, one mistake by Ambrose.
Last
turn, win this thing.
Down in the hairpin here, Andy. This is where he's got to try to get it done.
If he's going to dive on him, it could be here.
And he tried. He's made a move here.
Going to go high, low on him.
Right off the corner.
Can he get the grip?
It's the grip. He's trying to fight that grip off the corner.
All right.
He gets in the bumper. He's pushing Ambrose.
Yeah. Now he's got it. One more chance going into 13. Marcus taking the defensive line down the middle, saying, if you're going to go, you're going to tell me where you're going first. Here he comes into 13.
Well, Carl Edwards is doing everything he can right here.
Marcus, big time hurt. It will be the fifth time in his career that he has pulled this maneuver off. Third time this year, he's got over second place, Kevin Harvick. So everybody who said, I can't drive because my foot's broken, forget it. The big question is now, how's he do the backflip?
Will not be a green-white checker today. They could have had my money on that.
Around, bud.
Carl Edwards to the white flag. Doc?
And it is a motor issue with the 32 car. It is internal in the engine. It is popping and missing and sputtering and getting worse. They're going to try to milk this thing for one more lap and finish. What a gallant effort today. A gallant effort for Jacques Villeneuve.
Boy, Doc, you got that right. This guy has been a great driver today. He's really been flying. Hate to see this happen to this team.
So Carl Edwards now with a gap back to Ron Fellows of almost 3 seconds on his white flag lap. If he gets it around to the finish line, he'll have led 35 of the 50 laps today. It had its moments, but he has been dominant, that's for sure. Up the hill, turn number 6 for the final time.
Did not practice on Friday over in Sears Point, qualifying the cup car. He practiced a little test session they had on Thursday. He was the fastest car in that session.
He got on me the other day. I roughed him up a little bit for not testing in Kentucky. He said, hey, Rusty, I mean, come on. I'm trying to make...
Tony Abe going around.
Oh.
Both Abe and Paul Menard spun.
But I told Carl, you tested here, and you qualified great. Looks like he's getting ready to win this race. Just proves that practice is good.
It does help.
Off the carousel corner, down to the kink. And then he'll head for Kettle Bottoms for the final time in Canada Corner. Carl Edwards, less than half a lap from Victory Lane. Ford, winless so far, 2010. Remember they told us a couple of weeks ago at Nashville, Jack Roush came out and said on a Ford media conference call, they had found some parts that weren't up to their specifications, had removed them, replaced them in their system, started running better that week in Nashville. A couple of second place finishes for Carl, and now he's going to make it
third
week in a top two finish, and he's going to win this one.
Well, it sounds like Jack knows what he's talking about. His whole team has done a fantastic job for him.
Final time up the hill. The first name on the winner's trophy at Road America in the NASCAR Nationwide Series will be Carl Edwards. He dominates and wins the Bucyrus 200.
Brad Keselowski, Carl Edwards bringing it to green, watching the flag, but now keeping their eye on that restart zone. Keselowski stands in the gas. Carl's with him as they cross the start-finish line.
Carl did a good job. He's maintaining there. He needs to do that if he's got any chance.
He's got to keep that high side going right now.
That was a great restart with Keselowski. He really came through the gearbox good.
Look at Brad. He tries to drift to the high side. Carl fights back. It's not over yet.
I thought he had him cleared.
Look just how close it is. Does Carl dive in on the outside? He's got to do it. Does he maintain that spot? Keselowski holds him off. Carl with the advantage coming off the corner.
Keselowski got a little bit loose getting into three.
White flag.
Shades of Atlanta for Carl's first cup.
Nine right on your bumper. White flag.
To the
one
outside,
more time.
But he's got one more lap to deal with Brad Keselowski. Keselowski fights back on the inside.
Whatever happens now, this race
will be a touch. Keselowski gets into Edwards. They save it. Drag race down the backstretch now.
That's that half car length I was talking about. They both survived it. Let's see what happens in turn three.
Reed Sorensen waiting in the wings. Here's Keselowski on the inside. Carl Edwards, can he make it stick on the outside? Brad thought he had the best car all night. Took the inside line on the restart. This is going to be down to the wire. Oh, high touch. He spun out. Carl gets into Keselowski.
Oh,
Carl Edwards will win.
That's it. Checker flag.
White flag out, a mile and a half to go. Carl Edwards looking for win number 3 of 2010. He's not going to win the championship, but it looks like he's going to win this race. Down the backstretch, Kyle Busch not going to be able to even give him a challenge. And the man in third, the butterflies in his stomach have got to be just enormous. Carl comes and
awesome,
takes the checker.
Yeah, buddy, come get the checkered flag.
And here great comes job. Your champion. If he finishes it off, it'll be the fourth time he has won back-to-back, and it'll be his fourth win of 2010. And is this a precursor of tomorrow? Because he'll start on pole for the Sprint Cup race here at Phoenix International Raceway. Coming out of turn number 4, who cares that the sun's in your eyes? There's the checkered flag, and the winner, Carl Edwards.
Well, it's not going to happen now.
Nope, that's it
that's
right there.
It. White flag is out. Here we go. There's Carl Edwards trying to get under the 26 of Kevin Conway. Conway gives him plenty of room. Heard the crew tell him, just bring it on home. 2.6 seconds the gap, and it looks like the championship is going to last at least till we get to Miami, because here comes Carl Edwards for his 25th Nationwide Series win in his 175th start, as he takes the win by 2.6 seconds.
Final lap here. Here comes Jeff Burton around. And the big question is, can Jimmy Johnson make it on fuel?
He's kept Kevin Harvick behind him also, watching the battle.
Carl Edwards down
nice
in the
team, bud. You only got 3/4 of a lap. Yeah, I think you need to.
There it is.
42 out of gas in front of you on the bottom.
You heard it. Montoya has run out of fuel, but here comes Carl Edwards. He's done it. He swept the weekend. There it is. Just one
white
more
flag.
Circuit.
Need one good lap.
Nothing any of these guys can do. That hammering you hear is the sound of the nail of the final coffin on the Chase contenders' hopes of upsetting Jimmy Johnson.
Got a lot of champagne. Half a lap, bud.
Carl Edwards is going to win the race, but coming through turns 3 and 4, the championship is going to go to Jimmy Johnson. And if you don't think he's going to be one of the greatest, think again.
You're looking at the five-time champion.
You're looking at him. He wins 2 in a row.
Round turn 3 and into 4. Stewart packed it in there. But Carl Edwards. Carl Edwards gives Ford its fourth win in the last 5 races. Edwards wins the Cobalt Tools 400.
Well, Edwards putting in a dominating performance. He has never been lower than third the entire evening. And here he is just a couple corners away after winning the pole earlier today. Here he comes out of turn number 4. Keselowski tries to come as low as he can to cut the margin. But Carl Edwards is going to pick up win number 1 in 2011.
Scremmy yields to him.
Yep.
Carl sees a clear track in front of him.
There's nothing Kyle Busch can do at this point. Turns 3 and 4. Kyle making one last desperate charge, but the time and distance is going to run out. For his 31st time in his career, Carl Edwards sees the checkered flag first, with Kyle Busch coming across in second. In the air. Does he get as good a start this time? No. Here comes Joey.
Yeah, Logano's there. I think Carl spun the tires a little bit that time.
Through the corner. Still on his fender. On the high side. Logano going for it. They're down the backstretch. Logano with a half a car length on him. Now here comes Carl back on the low side.
Oh, Carl
slips
a little.
Come on, he's sideways.
Oh, now he gets it. Logano. Joey. Joey's into the bar and the car's upside down. On his side is Clint.
Yellow is out.
Gets into it. The 14 of Bliss gets into it.
The Detroit hometown race for Jack Roush and Roush Fenway Racing looks like it's going to wind up in a 1-2 finish as Carl Edwards is in his final corner. He'll come to the checkered flag and score the victory in Michigan over his teammate Ricky Stenhouse Jr. It is Ford first in its own hometown.
Thank y'all so much. I'm so blessed to have you.
1.3 miles separating Carl Edwards from his victory number 34 in his career. Down the backstretch for the final time. And there you can see Ricky Stenhouse Jr. just cannot close the gap. Coming through 3 and 4. Carl Edwards is going to lead 124 laps tonight and pick up his 5th win of 2011 here at Nashville.
And he has 1.5 miles to go. And Carl Edwards, remember, he won this race from pole back in 2005. And oh, he got loose there.
Wow.
Kyle is pushing for all he's worth, but it's not going to be enough. He'll be the 4th man to win from pole here in Atlanta, the Nationwide Series, as he's bringing it around the final corners. And it is going to be Carl Edwards taking the win here in Atlanta. Kyle Busch closes to second.
Remember, he told us before the race, he said, my cup car is better than my Nationwide car. Well, he is going to lead 179 laps. And Carl Edwards coming through the last couple of corners. Slower traffic ahead of him, but it's not going to deter him. Here at Dover, Carl's going to win on the concrete again.
Go. Edwards with Kyle Busch bearing down on him. Elliott Sadler in command for the bonus. Busch to the inside. Can he get the lead in the final half lap? Not that corner. One more set of turns. Big run to the bottom, but it's not going to be enough. Carl Edwards is going to have another incredible rally and come all the way back to win tonight in Charlotte.
Get ready, because we'll have two laps remaining when we go green.
Green, green, green.
There's Sam Hornish really spun the tires on trying to get going.
And here comes Kyle. But Carl's going to be first to the corner. Sam lights him up.
Whoa. Sam's got the inside spot over Brad, but can't make that stick.
Ricky Stenhouse Jr. there in the sixth car in fourth. Kyle Busch running in fifth. But Carl Edwards got the restart he wanted, guys. Heading down for the inner loop. Brad's able to close a little bit of that gap. Sam Hornish Jr. doing a fine job. He's maintaining that third position. Stenhouse also right there in fourth. Heading for turn number six, it is still Carl Edwards and Brad Keselowski. Keselowski, as Carl goes a little wide.
Gonna try that high side. You're out of turn seven. Don't see this happen much.
Oh, and man, right up against the wall.
White flag, I think, got against the wall coming off seven.
White flag is out, so one lap to go.
And you got to get it, because anything can happen if you create a caution flag here on this last lap.
Sam gets up over the curb, so does Stenhouse.
Carl gets a big run up through the S's.
Wait, Hornish is driving the wheels off that 12 car. Coming down the straightaway, heading for the inner loop. Edwards has opened up a sizable gap. Keselowski in second, Hornish third, then is Ricky Stenhouse Jr. Hornish all over the 22. Remember, these guys are teammates.
Yeah, doesn't dare put the bumper to that 22. Try to pick up another spot.
Heading for turn six. There's only two corners left. Carl Edwards makes the corner easily. And boy, what a welcome back to the NASCAR Nationwide Series. The former champion is going to win here at Watkins Glen.
Great job, guys.
Carl Edwards, if he doesn't run out of fuel, look at Keselowski. He and Jimmy Johnson are hanging into each other.
Here comes Denny Hamlin. He'll go on the apron.
Hamlin, he's on the apron. This could get big when they get to three.
Hamlin could be in second going into turn
three.
Can
he hold it down? No, yes, he can. He got it.
Winless streak over. Off turn four. Carl Edwards wins the Subway Fenway 500. Oh, Johnson and Hamlin in a fender banging finish for second.
Newman and Truex fighting for a wild card spot on the last lap. Truex has got to pass somebody in these final two corners to get in. Carl Edwards is going to win the race.
Got a yellow.
Caution with three laps to go.
Yeah, he needed about two more laps to get to that white flag and we'd have had a race, but again, the trends normally speaks the truth. I take that back. I think Jimmy Finney just got excited.
Caution is out with two to go, and we're waiting word of why from NASCAR control.
Everybody's looking around like, what happened? Nobody knows.
That's a stunner.
Nobody knows what the yellow's for.
Well, good. I'm glad we're not the only ones in the dark.
Yeah.
But the caution light's illuminated with 2.5 laps to go.
Yellow checker this time, I believe.
That's what I'd do.
We're coming up on 503 laps.
You'll be getting it here.
The fans waited.
Good job, buddy. Good job,
2 hours this afternoon, over 3 hours tonight. Enough. Mother Nature wins, and so does Carl Edwards.
Yeah, that was a pretty conservative lap. We saw the car step out, getting into turn seven a little bit, kind of bad. Made his way through the S's and was very, very careful getting into turn 11. And it goes back to what Larry says. You get to that white flag lap, then you just got to maintain this pace.
Going to be no overtime today in Sonoma. The leaders working their way off of turn four for the final time this afternoon. Down to turn seven, one of those passing zones, but Gordon not close enough to make anything happen.
Boy, Jeff is, I know he's running everything he's got right now.
And this,
because he's only got one more shot at it, and I don't think he's going to be able to get close enough. But
and we've seen that 99 smoke the tires of Carl Edwards, or smoke the tires getting into turn seven the last two or three laps.
Through the high speed portion of the track for the final time, Gordon closing in as they head toward turn 11. Gordon driving it in hard. Edwards locks it down, maintains the top spot, and drives off of turn 11 clean. He's won 22 times in his career, but never on a road course. That's going to change today. Carl Edwards, a winner at Sonoma.
Half a straightaway back and slowing. White flag one more time.
One more time, baby, if you can do it.
Biffle 4 seconds back. Earnhardt may catch him.
I'm holding my breath, Larry.
Carl Edwards.
And so is Carl.
Makes the move to Joe Gibbs Racing and Toyota pay off as he comes off turn number four to win the Coca-Cola 600.
He did it.
By about 5 seconds over Greg Biffle.
Holy guacamole, buddy. Awesome, awesome job.
The white flag is out. One more time at Darlington. Carl Edwards, earlier this year, won at Charlotte in a 600-mile race, and now the longest race of the year time-wise down the backstretch for the final time. Carl Edwards, as he comes through three and four, he'll see the checkered flag. He'll add his name to the legends that have won at Darlington. Carl Edwards wins the Southern 500.
And that, boy, they are Carl Edwards' best friend right now.
Oh, yeah.
Boy,
I'm loving this.
That was some great, oh, my gosh, that was great short track racing right there.
And then you got Chase Elliott.
Oh, we got 41 got loose off the two. Here comes Chase.
White flag one more time.
White flag. One lap to go. Sponsored by Credit One Bank. Carl Edwards well out in front of a great battle for second place. Earnhardt, Busch, Elliott, and Bain for the top five. Checkered flag in the air. Carl Edwards dominates Bristol.
Remember when we saw the battle between Jimmy Johnson and Carl Edwards at the beginning of this race? And we felt like, well, Jimmy's got, he has control. He bobbled one time, got loose off of turn two, and Carl went right on by him. That's all it could possibly take for Kyle Busch to lose this race.
Great corner that time off two by the 18 car. He opened that gap back up on Carl. Carl is driving so hard, he's getting loose.
Clear there. 30 should stay bottom.
Josh Wise ahead on the bottom, and then Ricky Stenhouse, who was the last car on the lead lap.
There he comes on the bottom again. He tries to get up off that corner, but he just can't accelerate out of that hole over there to get to the back bumper.
Yeah, his car really rolls to the center, but it doesn't seem to have as good a drive off.
No, I think Kyle's got this. He's just good enough that Carl can't get to it.
Two more laps.
I know Carl Edwards. He's about to bite that steering wheel.
Where the spotters start running to the other spotters saying, all right, we got one lap to go.
White flag, one lap to go, sponsored by Credit One Bank. And here it is. Here's the move.
Look at this. Content. Did they make contact?
Oh, I don't know. It's pretty close, but this is going to be a drag race.
Last gas, turn three, last lap. Traffic ahead. Kyle Busch the leader.
Look at this.
Carl Edwards right there. Moves him to win it. Carl Edwards, bump and dump and run.
Oh, God.
How did he pull that off?
That's a teammate.
See the raindrops coming.
was able to hang on to the lead, and now precipitation one more time.
What an incredible job by the 19 driver, Carl Edwards, by the team, bringing a car that had the pace to keep the lead after the pit crew got them the lead. This win, if it ends up being a win for the 19 car, was truly a team effort. And I think, you know, that's a great wave to ride into Miami. Think about how close he came to winning a championship, tying Tony Stewart in the points. With the crew, gas man, jack man, tire changes, tire carriers. Those six gentlemen right there put that 11-second pit stop together that got Carl Edwards the lead.
And I think it's fair to say that they were all the best tonight when they needed to be. They had more speed tonight than they've had at the chase. They gave themselves a shot. They gave the pit crew a shot. They gave the driver a shot. They all worked together to put themselves in this position. And when they got in that position, they capitalized on it.
It wasn't officially a must-win situation for Carl Edwards entering this race, although he was 32 points down when he entered. Of the eighth, he was currently eighth. But they took it on as a must-win situation. This team knew they needed to put everything together tonight to give them an opportunity to still run for a championship.